Jonas' new single, Jealous.
You know, I can't help but relate to the words in his song. They're so catchy and relevant.
Not only are they catchy, Lauren, but Nick's words also speak to us as a whole about what it's like to be jealous.
Speaking of which, we'd like to thank you for joining us this Thursday evening for our special topic on jealousy. This is Lauren, Alexa, and Allie from SPC News Studio 3210.
On tonight's segment, we were specifically asked by our viewers to shed some light on how social media technology contributes to jealousy in romantic relationships.
You all asked, and after researching, we're here to give you the answers.
So, Allie, what does it mean to be jealous in a romantic relationship?
Well, Alexa, based on our findings, romantic jealousy occurs when individuals perceive rivals as a threat in their relationship. And in turn, this motivates individuals to defend their relationship.
In fact, researchers agree that jealousy involves three related components. Emotions including anger, sadness, fear, and anxiety. Thoughts such as suspicions or worries about the situation. And lastly, behaviors.
Researchers have identified four main triggers of jealousy. When a partner shows interest in another, when another shows interest in a partner, when a partner interacts with a past boyfriend or girlfriend, and lastly, ambiguous scenes involving a partner.
So with these findings, can we conclude that jealousy can have a significant impact on romantic relationships?
Alexa, that's exactly why we asked Dr. Leah Lefebvre to come into the studio and answer some questions we prepared in regard to social media and communication, and what that is doing to make partners jealous in romantic relationships.
Well, with that said, it's time for a special treat. Joining us in Studio 3210 with the exclusive interview on this topic is expert Dr. Leah Lefebvre on behalf of the International Association of Relationship Research.
In the last decade, the increased popularity of social networking has profoundly influenced the nature of relational communication. An even more popular form of communication for couples is texting. Texting has been found to have the strongest association with individuals' positives and negatives within their relationship, with expressing affection being the most common reason for contact. Social network sites have dominated internet traffic as individuals logged in daily to check statuses, post articles, and upload photos. Our research suggests that the frequent use of Facebook by individuals in relationships has been found to relate to some measures of jealousy. For example, when a partner adds a member of the opposite sex as a friend, suspicion and jealousy follows. Another commonly reported behavior is interpersonal electronic surveillance. These behaviors indicated that respondents felt the need to observe their romantic partner's online actions. With that being said, the association between Facebook and jealousy is recurrent. Facebook exposes us to jealousy triggers. Jealousy leads to snooping on Facebook, and snooping exposes us to more potential jealousy triggers.
Thank you, Dr. Lefebvre, for that illuminating interview.
It's crazy how much social media is affecting us.
Seriously, it's almost like the majority of relationships now are happening through cyberspace.
And our expert didn't even get a chance to talk about partner monitoring, which is incredibly common now.
What specifically is partner monitoring?
Well, if you've heard of the term Facebook creeping, then you already have a good idea of what it is. Basically, it's when you access your significant other's Facebook.
Yeah, I'll admit to being guilty of that. But is it really that common?
It sure is. According to a study, more than 60% of college-age students say that they monitor their partner's social media use.
Well, they're not just monitoring their partners.
What do you mean?
Well, one thing about social media, and not only Facebook, but Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, etc., is that now the back burner phenomenon is stronger than ever.
What's the back burner phenomenon?
Well, this might depress you if you're in a relationship, but a back burner is someone that you have an interest in, but you're not specifically dating. Social media, text, Skype, basically all forms of communication make it easier to maintain these backdoor friends and keep them as options for potential romantic partners.
Why would this depress me if I were in a relationship? I'd imagine people are less likely to have back burners if they're in a committed relationship.
Unfortunately not. It is more common with guys, but the average college student in a relationship has an average of 2 back burners at any given time.
But why would technology and social media make this more common?
Because now people can have secret text conversations or go creeping on someone they would potentially date if their current relationship failed.
I can't understand why people that are happily taken would do that.
There are a couple different reasons. Some people like to have a safety net in case their current relationship fails. Sometimes if people know they're gonna break up, they want someone ready they can jump ship to. Sometimes it's just about keeping an old fling alive.
Geez, maybe partner monitoring isn't that bad of an idea.
I think that's where the whole trust thing comes in.
Moving on, in preparation for this special, last week we asked our viewers to try to figure out what jealousy meant to them, film it, and then send it in to us.
Here are the two winners.
I remember when I lost my mind.
Yeah, so I'm getting pretty hungry. Do you want to get something after this?
Sure. I'm going to go to the bathroom.
Okay.
You want to get some froyo after we eat?
Why don't you get frozen yogurt with Jessica? I still get jealous.
What? Come on, man. You gotta be kidding me.
Yeah. Hawk's amazing book. Yeah, so funny.
How could you do this to me? He's my best friend.
Oh, no, we were just talking about Davis's new book.
It looked like more than that to me.
No, we only looked so happy because, well, how could you not look happy talking about FDR and fear itself?
Seriously, man, it wasn't anything. You don't have to worry about it.
I don't believe you. And I should have knew something was up when I seen you texting last night.
Hey, no, we were just putting up a study group. How did you know I was texting? Were you looking through my phone? Were you spying on me?
To think. I wore my best ties for you.
Wow, I'd imagine that not only people are creeping out of jealousy, but that the creeping is actually causing the jealousy.
But surely men and women aren't looking at the same things.
No, they're not. Turns out women are more likely to become jealous over activity between their significant other and a stranger. And men are more likely to become jealous over activity between their significant other and somebody they actually know.
Let's take it to the streets with our field reporter, John, to see how social media and technology contributes to jealousy in their romantic relationships.
Go.
Thanks, Alexa. I'm here outside of the studio looking for people to interview about the role of jealousy and social media and what roles they play in their lives and how it's different between men and women. Oh, look, here comes someone right now. Hi, excuse me, sir.
Oh, hey.
Hi, as you may know, social media is extremely prevalent in today's society. Would you agree with the statement?
I would, yeah. I think that you definitely have a good point there. And I actually read in one of my psych classes that men's jealousy is triggered more often by a partner's sexual infidelity rather than women's jealousy is triggered by emotional infidelity.
Interesting, I didn't know that. Now, how does social media play a role in that?
Well, internet infidelity poses new challenges in today's couples. What is said and done online causes jealousy in life.
That makes a lot of sense. I never knew that. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
Have a good day. Hi, I'm here with Kristen Harrison, and I'm interviewing her about the difference between men and women and how they react to jealousy, especially through social media.
What a coincidence. I actually was a part of a group that researched this topic.
No way. Could you tell me a little bit more about it?
Sure. I was part of a group that filled out a Facebook jealousy questionnaire, and what we found was that women were more prone to Facebook jealousy behaviors and to act on their jealousy throughout all social media.
No way. And now, was this research exclusively focused on women?
No, we had men in the research as well. We found that they were more aware of their partner's jealousy in social media than women were.
No way. I would have never expected men to be prone to this type of behavior.
Yeah, it was a pretty interesting research group to be a part of, but I'm late for a meeting, so thank you for having me.
All right, thank you so much. Have a nice day. Wow, we've run into so many knowledgeable people today. Let's see if we can find one more person to interview. Hi, excuse me, ma'am. Do you have a minute?
Yeah, sure. What's up?
I'm interviewing people about the role of jealousy and social media in their lives. Could you talk to me a little bit about this?
Oh, yeah. Self-esteem plays a huge role in jealousy. There's also two types. There's implicit and explicit self-esteem.
Wow, I didn't know self-esteem played such a large role. Could you tell me the difference between implicit and explicit?
Yeah, for sure. Implicit self-esteem is driven by more habitual and automatic responses. So, for example, the sense of accomplishment you get when you complete a goal. Whereas, on the other hand, explicit self-esteem is more intentionally and deliberately like created. So that would look like maybe you receiving a compliment from someone that you know or recognition. And in this case, it would be your romantic partner.
Fascinating. My self-esteem is definitely made up of both. Could you tell me how it differentiates between men and women?
Yeah, for sure. Well, men who experience higher levels of jealousy tend to have higher levels of explicit self-esteem, where on the other hand, women who experience higher levels of jealousy tend to have lower levels of implicit self-esteem. So it's sort of inverse.
I would never have expected that. And finally, can you tell me how social media and technology affect this?
Right. Well, in today's world, social media has made us as a whole completely connected. So with relationships nowadays having some virtual aspect to them, wherever it may be, it's easy to see how social media and technology can cause problems between couples through jealousy and self-esteem. For example, how would you feel if your romantic partner, like your boyfriend or girlfriend, liked their ex's risque Instagram picture? How would you feel?
I would not appreciate them posting themselves all over the internet.
Exactly. I'm sure you would feel jealous and your self-esteem would go way down.
Oh, definitely. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I never thought about it that way. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Of course. Have a good one, guys.
All right. You too. Wow, we've learned a lot today. We learned that men's jealousy is more likely triggered by sexual infidelity, while women's jealousy is more likely triggered by emotional infidelity. Additionally, we learned that women are more prone to Facebook-evoked feelings of jealousy than men, but men are more perceptive of it. And finally, we learned that implicit and explicit self-esteem contribute to jealousy as well. Back to Studio 3210 for some positive advice on how you can cope with jealousy in your own relationship.
Thanks, John.
Well, isn't that interesting?
Absolutely. You know, jealousy can really take a toll on a couple's well-being. And even though jealousy may feel awful at the time, there are some positive repercussions that come with the green-eyed monster.
That is true, Lauren. Did you know that jealousy could potentially increase the commitment and happiness between couples?
Really? Everything we've discussed seems so negative. Is there really something good that can come out of jealousy in romantic relationships?
Well, according to Angela Neal of the University of New Hampshire, when a person perceives their partner falling victim to the temptation of another person, perceivers respond to this notion with relationship-protecting behaviors. In turn, the tempted partner notices this mate-guarding behavior from his or her partner, which actually increases the commitment to the tempted partner, in some cases.
Absolutely, I can see how that would make sense. In addition to positive outcomes, though, healthy ways to manage relationships need to be known. According to Dr. Jennifer Beaven of Science of Relationships, monitoring a jealous situation with your partner could make all the difference. She also strongly suggests communicating your jealousy in a positive, integrative manner, which could ultimately help your partner respond in a calm way as well.
And don't forget to take your partner's perspective into account. Relationships are a two-way street, after all.
With all of this being said, jealousy is a natural emotion that everyone feels at some point in a relationship, and there are many factors that can cause it.
Social media specifically has a huge influence on the way people perceive and maneuver through romantic relationships, making it really easy for jealousy to arise.
A special thank you to our viewers for bringing this topic to light. We know this is something that people deal with on an everyday basis, and social media makes it impossible to escape. Please send us your feedback and let us know if this special has answered the question of how social media and technology contribute to jealousy in romantic relationships.
We hope you all enjoyed our broadcast, and until next time, this is SPC News. I turn my chill music up, and I'm puffing my